Okay, so going from a two bedroom, two bath as my first studio, and then building, I actually left the smaller gyms, went to Gold's, and then from Gold's to the two bedroom, two bath. And I had hired my first coach and developed some nutrition training systems. I made some online courses from my first mastermind coach, hooked up with my second mastermind coach a couple of times. And this was allowing me to start marketing and presenting a lot of what I did with my boot camp. So I built out my boot camp models to the nth degree, and then my group classes. And I had already kind of started dealing with Mr. Fat Loss. And I also started dealing with some of the local celebrities. And so I was creating this machine using the semi-private model and all of the different things that I'd learned from the other mastermind coaches and education I'd had. At this point, we're probably in early 2000, and I mentioned, the 9/11, all of that. And so as I'm moving forward, I start to get a little cramped in the space. And so we had to get another space. And so we ended up purchasing a loft through another contact of mine, helped me, move up the food chain, if you will, and get into another unit. And it was right at the stock market, no, the housing bubble. And so we bought a loft, and promptly within 2 years, it just decreased in value. But I had taken my training model that I was in the two bedroom, two bath, and I moved it into the loft. And so now here's where, that $800 a month per person kind of scenario was going crazy. I had some local bodybuilders that were coming to me for soft tissue work. I was doing the group training inside the loft, same model, couple groups in the morning, couple groups at night. And I outgrew that space pretty quickly because my clients, I mean, my neighbors were getting sideways. They were so sideways. I had all these people coming in the building. It's a pimped out building. It's nice. But right at that point when our housing bubble burst, there was a countrywide, an office downstairs on Pine Avenue in Long Beach, and they had a space that just was like, I just looked out the window and it was just right downstairs. And so I went into that space and we took a look at it. And B Fox, she had like this, I was like the technician. I could do the training program, design everything that we needed to have. But she had a vision, and we turned, painted the whole thing white, had, classic wooden floors in it, and set it up. And the equipment that we had in the unit actually fit really well there in the studio. And then we added some flat screens, put some big mirrors in, and turned it into like a beauty spa slash high-end boutique with design within reach. She had an eye for, like, you want to talk about gym equipment? It's like furniture, the most expensive furniture that you could ever buy in your house. The design within reach is like all designer stuff. This is crazy. So she has this eye. So, we pimped out the studio, and then from there it was crazy. And we built the bikini teams, which is some of the other next phases that I would strongly recommend. And I learned this from another one of my mastermind coaches, and I was watching his model and I saw how he was doing it. But he was down in Orange County and did it a different way. And I wanted to deal with the physique world and the bikini models. So we had a team of about 12 to 15 girls. And then those girls, because of their overall look, just attracted, like they would go as a team into one of the gyms working out together. And like everybody was like, oh my God. Right. So they would wear the M2 Fitness Pro shirts and Team Fox shirts, go to these other locations, and it blew up. It absolutely blew up. And about that time within that group, a young cat, Long Beach, he came through. You might know him, Randall Pick from LVT, Live Fit. He rolls through and he wants to train his clients there. So I'm like, okay, yeah, cool. And I'm watching this kid and I'm just like, not really vibing too much, but just not getting his way. Just as long as he's paying his rent, he's doing his thing. When we're not there, we were still running that model. So we were only there in the mornings a little bit and a little bit in the afternoon, and another trainer or two would come in and use it with their base. So that presented another revenue model. Now, Randall, as you know, he and I had had a conversation one day, and you see a video about it. But I was asking, what are you doing in school? What are you studying? And, you know, he was talking about something. And I'm like looking at what he's doing and what I see going on for him physically and what I see going on with his overall vibe. I'm like, bro, you need to get out of that school, that traditional education, and try this out. Well, long story short, look him up. He blew up. And so he took something that was near and dear to him. And, you know, he understood that a fashion line was what he was doing. You know, I did, you know, shirts, hats, towels, all those kinds of things inside of Gold's, which was also another add-on that allowed me to charge $100 a session. But you go into, you know, some of the upper levels in this field and you can make an unbelievable amount of money. You need to ask yourself, how hard do you want to work? You need to ask yourself how hard of a struggle you've had your entire life and what does having that level of income mean to you? And then what are you willing to do to get it? What are you willing to do legitimately to make that kind of income so that you can better serve more people? So, you know, the model that we had and that I really am more passionate about is a physique and figure training specialist course. And then what transformation I've seen over my lifetime from my childhood all the way up, the impact that women have in their own life and in their world when they're in better shape than they may have previously been. I mean, not better shape, I'm talking ridiculous shape. So here, a young girl goes from just looking okay, maybe a cheerleader, maybe a softball player, maybe some track and field. But then we teach her how to polish that up and then put them in a bikini and put them on some stage and bam, they blow up. So we started to do all the flex bikini shows and we did, you know, B had did the Arnold, the first time it went from figure to bikini. The very first show I got her in, she won. And then she did and took the overall. And then she won another show and another show and another show. And so that opened my eyes up to the potential that she and I had to do the same kind of thing, not just through her, but her as Mother Bear. And he is, you know, my papa, daddy. And we would work with the girls and then try to kind of guide them with how we were doing the training model and then developing their physique career. Meanwhile, we're getting photo ops, we're getting magazine coverage, we're getting TV coverage. We got Dr. 90210. We did some TV, we did some radio, the local news, all these things. So it wasn't like we sat down and made this plan of we're going to do this and this and this. It just, it kind of happened. And at this time, we're at the third location, which is on Pine Avenue, as far as my training model. And this is going well. And one day I'm looking out the window and I see Tom Platz, Iron Eagle, walk by. I'm like, dude, my God. It's like another idol I see. He goes, oh yeah, I was coming by to check out your spot and I seen what you guys were doing. And at this time, you know, we had hired coaches, Dave Palumbo with B and Chris Aceto was someone else that we talked to and that I hired. Charles Glass was somebody that worked with B as we got ready. So I kind of lined her up and then Sean Ray took a liking to our crew of girls. And at this time, some of the other coaches, and I was looking at the bodybuilding scene. At that time I was out of it and didn't really want to do that, but the physique training and what was going on there. So I had tested this model on a major level and created a lot of bikini champs and pros and flex bikini winners and Arnold competitors. B took top of the heap as well. It went well. B actually got an opportunity to do a book with a physique competitor, a physique photographer, several of them. So, you know, things started to really gel together. And right about this time at the boutique training studio that we designed, Super Bowl has this tradition where they had GoDaddy commercials. And I'll tell you about that next.